am Marion Buricatu, a French-American artist. In less than 5 minutes, I'm going to make you an art expert. Just kidding.
Today I have my own special guest, and this is my son Thomas. Hello, Thomas.
Hello. Hello, everyone. So today we will be talking about our tourism in France this summer, and when we visited the Jean Lursa Museum in Angers, which is about 10 contemporary tapestries which were done in the 1960s. And so what's so interesting about this museum and the tapestries?
Well, this is a very interesting museum because it's about mixing centuries old technique of making tapestry with a contemporary subject. And it happened to be one of my favorite museums. So here are the three facts easy to remember about the tapestry by Jean Lursa. Fact number one, a very old hospital. Fact number two, the tapestry, a very old art form.
Okay.
And fact number three, le chant du monde, which means in English, the song of the world. Okay. Here is one of the tapestries in this museum called The Conquest of the Space, La Conquête de l'Espace.
Okay. So fact number one, a very old hospital. And what does a very old hospital have to do with tapestries?
Well, thank you for asking this question, Thomas. And in fact, it's because the tapestries are located in this architectural masterpiece of the 12th century that used to be a hospital with 360 beds.
Okay.
And as you can see on the picture, I particularly enjoy the opposition between the majestic white columns with the contemporary colorful tapestry, as you can see.
Also, this is a small museum, and they have, and there is a lunch and terrace in their nearby city of Angers, and you can also do some lovely shopping there.
Yes, that's the good thing about visiting a French city.
Yes. So, fact number two, the tapestries are very old in the art form.
Yes, and here's an example of the tapestry of the Apocalypse done in the 14th century.
Wow, that's kind of confusing.
Yes, because we're talking about a tapestry from the 1960s, and
right
now
this
it's just
tapestry is from the 1400s.
Yes, so what happened is that, unfortunately, since the Great Depression, this industry is not going well. And okay. The tapestries are very, very long to weave. So Jean Lursa really wants to help this art form. And so what he's going to do, he's going to conceive 10 tapestries in the 1960s to help the industry. So this whole museum is not only an art expression that is at stake here, but it's also technical and economical.
Okay, very interesting. And so fact number three, the chant du monde, or the song of the world in English.
So this is really Jean Lursa masterpiece.
How is it a masterpiece?
Because it's a poetic vision of the world. What happened is that Jean Lursa belongs to a generation of artists that was really shaken by two world wars, and by the threat of the atomic bomb. So this ensemble of tapestries is a message of hope and peace. So here you can see, you're gonna see the first and the eighth tapestry out of the 10. So as you can see on the screen, the first tapestry is called the Great Threat.
And so in this tapestry, I can see that things aren't really going well. On the left, there is a nuclear explosion, and on the right, there is a reference to Noah's Ark, which probably means a small amount of hope.
Yes, and the eighth tapestry that you can see now on the screen is called Champagne.
Ah, and I'm pretty sure this one shows life existing, being back and being joyous.
Yes, and joy is everywhere.
Yes.
So, here are the three facts.
So the three facts are a very old hospital. The fact number two is the tapestries are a very old art form. And fact number three is le chant du monde, or the song of the world.
Great, so now, if you're like me and you love, and honestly, this is such a passionate subject that if you want to learn more about that, you can look at the links below. Also, the next video is just for you because I have created 6 trivia questions about Le Chant du Monde.
Nice chatting with you. Abonne-toi, which means subscribe to my channel in French. Have fun and see you at the next video. Bye-bye.